Hi everyone, today in this video I'm going to talk about how to configure and use the Blazor components of Syncfusion in a Blazor server app. So I'll begin with what is Blazor and then I'll show you a simple depiction of how the Blazor server app works. Starting with the Blazor definition, I hope you all know it's a new web framework developed by Microsoft that is built on .NET. So you can start to create your own interactive web apps simply by using the C# and HTML. Although it supports both the server app and client-side WebAssembly app, in this video I have chosen to explain only about the Blazor server app and how easily you can add Syncfusion Blazor components to it. From the name Blazor server app, you can say that the Blazor components will run at the server side using the ASP.NET Core application. And the other UI updates, event handling, and interactions at the browser side are handled via the SignalR connection over the network. To establish the SignalR connection, the Blazor server app uses a particular script file reference, which is blazor.server.js. So by using this particular reference, it will send any UI updates or event handling interactions between the client and the server. Now let me begin to create my first server-side Blazor app. And for that, I should have the .NET Core SDK in my machine. And next, I should have either the Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019 installed in my machine. In this video, first I'll let you know how to create a Blazor server app using Visual Studio 2019. And at the later part, I'll also show you the same application creation process using Visual Studio Code. So let me open the Visual Studio 2019 now. And I'll start to create a new project by choosing the Create New Project from this dashboard. In the listed project templates, I'll choose Blazor App and click Next to proceed further with the project creation. Now I'll configure my project by giving it a unique name, My Blazor Project, and then I'll click the Create button to create a new project with the default configuration. And next I'll be asked to choose the Blazor project type. So here I'll select the Blazor Server App. So all is set. And I'll click the final create button to complete my Blazor project creation. And here in the Solution Explorer, you can look at the startup and other component files that are created under the project name My Blazor Project. Now let me explore a few built-in components that are available under the Pages folder. All these components, namely counter, fetch data, and index, are all built with the Razor extensions. So I'll open one of the components, say counter, and take a look at it. In any component, you can notice the page directive at the first line, and this line defines the route name and makes your component to be accessible from the browser. You can also find some HTML markups where you can place your component code, and the next code section, which contains the actual code logic of your component and application. Now I'll simply run this application and show you the default output first. You can see the home page first that displays whatever is defined in the index component, and you can navigate between these components listed in the menu. Now in this home page, I'll tell you the steps to add few of the Syncfusion components to it. So before I start to use Syncfusion Blazor components, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I'll open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet package. Then under the Browse tab, I'll search for syncfusion.blazor. So now I'll install this syncfusion.blazor into my project just by clicking this install button. Now once the package got installed into my application, you can check it under the dependencies folder. And within the packages folder, you can see that the syncfusion.blazor package being added into it. So there are just three more steps to follow to add a Syncfusion component to this Blazor project. As a first step, I'll open the imports.razor file. So here I need to add the syncfusion.blazor namespace, and I have planned to add the calendar component first. So to use the Syncfusion calendar component, I'll need to refer the namespace syncfusion.blazor. And now you'll get a list of component names. From that, I'm going to choose the calendars. Now the second step is to register the Syncfusion Blazor service. For that, I'll open the startup.cs file. Before I register the Syncfusion service, First, I'll refer the Syncfusion Blazor namespace here, syncfusion.blazor, and then within this configure services method, I need to make a call to the addSyncfusionBlazor method. And there is one more step here to register the valid license key. For that, within the configure method, I'll register the license using syncfusion.licensing.syncfusionLicenseProvider.registerLicense. And within this method, I need to provide the license key. I already have my own trial license key, so let me provide it here. In case if you are in need of trial key, you can check the start trials page in Syncfusion under your account. So here I have started my trial with the Blazor development. So within the trial download and keys, I can get the license key from here by choosing the appropriate version, get license key. It will provide me with a unique license key. So in this way, I got my trial key and applied that particular key in the startup file. Now moving on to the final step, I'll open the host.cshtml page. And here I need to refer the client-side resources like the required CSS to render the Syncfusion Blazor components. So within the head section, I'll add a reference for the CSS file first. Now everything is configured and let's see how to add the calendar component into this project. Let me open the index component and here I'll remove the default content and I'll add the calendar tag with the initial type value property tValue and I'll set it to date name. Now let me save the changes and run my application. And here you can see a simple calendar component getting displayed in the home page. In the same way, if I want to add some other component, say a grid component, I just need to do two things additionally. So inside the imports.razor file, I'll need to add the namespace of Blazor grid using syncfusion.blazor. And from list of component, I'm going to select grid. And the next step is I can directly add the grid component inside this index component or any of the components available in the pages folder. So after this calendar tag, I'll add grid. As a data grid needs some input data source to display them in a tabular format, therefore I'll add the code section here. And here I'll create a model class with the name employee. And also I have added few more valid fields to it like employee ID, name, designation, date of joining and salary. And then I'll override this onInitialized method within the code section. And within this method, I'll generate a list of employee data with the fields defined in this employee class. And now I'll bind this particular employee data variable to the grid's data source property. So I'll define data source property and assign employee data list variable and that's it. So let me save the changes and run the application. And here you can see a grid component displaying along with the calendar component in the same home page. So in this way, you can add any of the Syncfusion components to the Blazor server app and also configure them with its different available features. Now let's see how to create the same Blazor server app using Visual Studio Code. I have opened the Visual Studio Code and located it to the specific work location. Now to create a Blazor project, I'll open the integrated terminal and here I'll type in the command .NET new Blazor server -o and then I'll provide my project name as my Blazor project and hit the enter button. Let me navigate to the newly created project, cd my Blazor project. Next, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor packages into my project. For that, let me type in the command .NET add package syncfusion.blazor and hit the enter button. So this will install the latest version of the Syncfusion Blazor package. Now the Syncfusion Blazor packages are restored into my project. So I can start to configure the project now in the same way how I did before while using Visual Studio 2019. So in the imports.razor file, I'll add the namespace for calendars. And then inside the startup.cs file, I'll add the syncfusion.blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service inside this configure services method. by making a call to this addSyncFusionBlazor method, and then within the configure method, I need to register the license with a valid license key. And then I'll open the host.cshtml page under the pages folder. And here I'll add the reference to the SyncFusion CDN links for the required CSS to render the SyncFusion Blazor components. And finally, within the index component, I'll replace this default content with calendar tag. And let me save these changes. Now I'll run my project with the command .NET watch run and hit the enter button. So now I can view the output from a localhost 5000 or 5001. And here you can see the calendar component rendered on the home page. And that's really all you need to know while working with the SyncFusion Blazor components in a server-side Blazor app. Now let me summarize what we have seen so far. First, we have seen how the Blazor server app works and how to create a simple Blazor server app using Visual Studio 2019. Then we saw how to configure and add SyncFusion Blazor components like calendar and grid to the index component of the application. And at last, we also saw how to create the same Blazor server app using Visual Studio Code. To see the working of this example, you can download it from GitHub links, which I have shared in the below description part. If you find this video as useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel to get notified of our new videos. Thank you for watching this and stay tuned to watch my next video on how to add SyncFusion Blazor components to the Blazor WebAssembly application. Thank you.